Alrighty, greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Renegade Operative, and today I will be doing my first BTS or behind the scenes showcase. And the showcase is basically centered around the man who makes the machine and what makes the machine tick, whether it comes to applications that I might use, whether it comes to tutorials or things behind the hood, video ideas, things in question. I had behind the scenes on my head for a long time, and the first topic of contention that we're going to talk about is Discord, my experience with Discord, and overall giving you some tips and tricks that might prove beneficial if you're a beginner friendly content creator and you're first getting into content for the first time and you want to create a Discord server. Here's my experience. How did my community initially begin? Well, long story short, someone approached me about the idea of Discord. They said, hey, Renegade, you know, Discord is becoming the fresh hotness right now. Skype is being left in the dust. I was a Skype user back then, and I understood the pain, the arduous task of dealing with Skype, being bombarded by images constantly bombarding my hard drive and PC, and just having the overall feeling that Skype was behind the curve on applications. Eventually, he recommended me Discord, saying that this was a cool new forum-based community server thread that's being created. You should be a user right now. I think it would benefit you. And that's how it started. I made an account in 2016, I believe. It was a long time ago, but I made that account. I joined that server, and he said, this is your community server. I'm the one that made it for you. Here, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and it's going to be a fun time. And ultimately, he transferred ownership to me. I ended up making a survival horror server in 2020 as an extension server, because my first server was private. Nobody could join, and I toyed with the idea of making a public server. I wanted more public people, more public authorities to join the horror server, because I love survival horror. I thought survival horror was a great pastime, watching Jason take those big titty bimbos and slam them up against trees in sleeping bags. It was a fun time. It was funny as hell, right? It was the funniest thing ever, watching those movies, those Friday the 13th movies as a kid, and horror resonated with me deeply. So I figured, why not make an offshoot centered around horror based content like games and movies? So I have the variety server, which is for topics like comics, the fucking video games, movies, everything based in variety, Mass Effect, GTA, all of those big geek culture revelations, right? And then we have survival horror, about your Resident Evil, Silent Hill, indie horrors, all of that stuff you love is done over there. And I really like the differing dynamics between the two. Why should you make a Discord community? Well, Discord is fun. Your community should be fun as well. You're sharing the experience with plenty of people who probably have sub to you, or they are lingering around, or you might see them as fun, or you might have that one random chatter that you want to chat to them more often. That's one of the reasons of making a community, to bring people together. There's a few people that never understood that in the first place, but I digress. It's just bringing the subscribers, even potentially making this like a business, because you can also monetize your servers as well, put it behind Patreons or whatever. It's infinite options to do as a content creator, but you're still bringing those people together, and you're gonna want to embrace that and cherish that, because everyone starts from zero when crafting any sort of community. You're gonna start from zero, and then you'll go up to five, then you'll go up to 10, and then eventually, if you're super successful, you get to 100. You feel the power, you feel the heat right there. You get to 1000, you feel great. When you're building up that same community, it's also the same euphoria that you'll feel on Discord when you're doing something right. And that's where you want to be as you slowly build up your community. The next thing I want to talk about is, how hard is it to run a server? And as a server admin, it is very hard. I spent years going through rules, trials, and tribulations, which really can shake your entire foundation when you're starting out for the first time. You'll say, what the hell is happening? I don't understand what's going on. My poor boomer brain can't really grasp the idea and nature behind Discord for the first time. I feel lost. I get you there. But one of the things that you're going to have to realize is you're going to have to ask questions. Asking questions about certain applications, bots, is really important. Uncovering the layers of how things work are really important. Tutorials save my life, man. They save my ass on each and every single situation. I always go to YouTube and type that in the key search bar, and I find out what do I need, how do I do it, and which is the way to approach the matter. And I think talking to either creators behind moderation bots or creators behind making Discord servers can make your life so much easier. You have no idea. One channel I'm going to recommend, and you'll see my screen pop up right here, is Jester. He has tutorials based on Discord, and they are really, really good for beginners. I thoroughly recommend this channel. I cannot recommend it enough. He has a bot that will set up your personal server for you at the drop of a hat, doing commands, and it's less than a minute. You could check that out. Then he has bots where it's for moderation. If you want filthy words to be filtered out of your Discord, then you could use the Sapphire bot right here in this tutorial, and never use Meep 6 because it's an NFT, whatever the fuck, piece of garbage. I can't stand Meep 6. You definitely don't want to use it. And then he will also help you with this Fiverr store of setting up your own personal Discord server. He will take the donation of about 60 bucks. If you do that and pay him, then he'll set this whole entire professional tutorialized Discord for your needs. Auto moderation, reaction roles, everything you need for $60. I firmly believe in Jester. I think if you give him a chance, he will definitely help you out. 5-star reviews, the man is amazing, and I would say if you need to start somewhere with server creation and you don't know how to get it or where to get it, check out Jester, whether you're making your own Discord or if you're paying him to do so. The last person I would recommend if you're doing server creation or trying to find things online for Discord is Mr. No Text to Speech, and he has like a bunch of tutorials. Some of them might be outdated, but he does a lot on showing you how to do onboarding, which is what you need to show people how I level up my Discord and how do I show others what are the proper channels they want to see. This man is the man that will teach you anything you need, and this is the playlist where he has it on his channel. It's called the Discord tutorial, and you can find out, check that out, and look at all the fun little tips, tricks, and cheats that Mr. No Text to Speech has to offer the community. I'm gonna rapid fire these last few questions really quickly. What tips can I give personally to beginning content creators who want to make their own unique Discord community? Alright, first and foremost, you need to be proactive in your own Discord. I can't stress this enough. I would say the server administrator should be the most active member. Download Discord on your phone, talk to people, strike conversations. You are the server owner. Actually show you give a damn. I'm a little bit blunt with that, but it's true. You have to show you give a damn. You're going to have to try to engage. It's the only way for the people there. Try the best you can to be lively. Say hi, greet people. People love the welcoming side of a person and the content creator they care about and follow. It makes that rule really, really important. Next step is to network with people and seek community members. This is going to be kind of a slope. I personally hate networking. I do. I don't like it, but you have to if you want to grow a place. If you want to get fans involved that may not know, then going out and talking, causing an organic conversation is the way to do it. Please do not run into someone's server and try to say, hey, my name is T-Rex Dick McGee. I'm going to post my Discord server all over your server in hopes that your members will join my server. You look like a damn fool when you do that. Don't do inorganic networking. Try to greet people, make friends, say hi, share interests, see where it goes, and then pop the question, hey, do you want to marry me? No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. No, do you want to join my Discord server? I have hookers and blackjack over here, and try to, you know, put a little finesse on top of it. A little finesse goes a long way, and that's how I managed to get like about 500 members, 1,000 members. You gotta be suave out here. You gotta show you have something cool. That's the best way to do it. You know, put a little bit of that funk on it and make it your own, and try to have that sort of social interaction that makes it fun. Next, keep the community safe with moderators and moderation tools. This is very simple. Try to find a staff of 5 that you fuck with, that you're cool with, and say, hey, do you want to moderate my Discord? We talk here a lot. Why not have moderation where you could have friends that will watch the Discord if you happen to be asleep or out or on vacation? That's very cool to have those human moderators there. The moderation tools itself, like Sapphire Bot, will help detect people say those naughty words to get rid of them, to have things pop up that you might need to remind people of. Is very important to have moderator tools that understand. Jester has a lot of tutorials as well on Sapphire Bot, and I will be linking as much as possible in the motherfucking description, baby. What else? Have a clear-cut theme to your Discord server if you're making one. Please do. Don't just say something to the equivalent of I like cookies, because there's a lot of cookies in the stratosphere, like sugar cookies, oatmeal cookies, raisin cookies, chocolate chip, macadamia. Which cookies are we talking about? You want to have a clear-cut theme to what is transpiring in your Discord, and I think that really helps to set it up and have it aesthetically pleasing as possible. Descriptions all filled out, that really helps, because it will show people, hey, I know it's hard to read in 2023, but there's still like reading and descriptions applied to your said server. That's really important. You're gonna want to have all that front row and present it, so when it comes to those individualized topics, people can know what are the do's and don'ts of the server. Next up, keep your advertisements and notifications regulated. All right, one thing I see people do in their servers, and it's nothing wrong with this, but there's a way to go about this shit, right? Is when they decide to have live streams and YouTube videos they post on their channel. They want to share it with their community, their watchers, their subscribers. Nothing wrong with that. One thing I noticed though is when you join a content creator's Discord and they keep adding everyone, hey, watch my videos, watch my Fortnite 360 no scopes, watch this, watch that, constantly spamming the everyone tag, and the notifications blow up. People don't like notification spam. I'm sorry to break it to you like this, but it's true. They don't like it. What you're going to want to do is to regulate that channel behind a role. Let me give an example. If someone presses the YouTube role in my rules and roles, and let's say hypothetically they get it right, they say, oh, this is for IAS content creation, then they could press that notification button and it will be on their person, and due to that they know that they have subscribed to pings. Therefore, if the Infinite Ammo Syndicate makes a video and it adds everyone in a certain channel, once you set it up and they put that bell ping on their name, then only that person will get those notifications and text channels. If they don't press it, they don't see anything. You're going to want to set up your server in a way where it has that, so everyone is not getting bombarded with the @everyone tag. Next up, do not create too many channels in your Discord and make things disorienting. I think that is self-explanatory. You're going to want to condense channels. You like, for me, for instance, I have a pets channel, I have a selfies channel, I have a food channel, because what purpose do they serve? You're all taking pictures of something. You're taking pictures of your food, which is nice and neat, and that pizza is sexy as fuck and thick as fuck, like a hooker at Athena Academia. I don't know what I'm saying anymore, it's late as fuck. But still, you're taking a picture of your food, or you're taking a picture of your pet, or you're taking a picture of yourself. It doesn't need three separate channels, because the functionality could all be under one channel, hence why I have a channel called Pets, Selfies, and Food. Other things to bring up is you're going to want to have like fair and illustrated rules, because if your rules absolutely make no sense, like, oh, if you don't watch my streams, I'm going to kick you out, then that's going to disintegrate engagement. You're going to want to have rules that are fair and it makes sense to the overall Discord, not shadow rules or anything of that nature, something that will blindside people if they don't participate enough, just something that makes total sense. You shouldn't be spamming the idea of kicking someone out anyway just because they don't watch your live streams or videos, etc. You're gonna want to be more fair, open, and honest to your community so they can know what is going down. But don't be afraid to create rules or put rules in play. I feel like that needs to be established as well. They could be fair rules, but they could be rules that, once again, the user shouldn't go around and be breaking them, because the place is not an asylum. And then you're going to want to have things culminate with time. Things take time. Rome wasn't built in a day, and neither would your Discord server be as well. It takes time, patience, and application, and you're going to be in this for the long haul if you want a successful community. I am now going to do the segment where I sort of do a tour. You can see all the videos and self-help in the description for making your own server, but just gonna take you on a slight tour for mine so you can see how things are going. Let me press the button here. Oh, there we go. And there you can see everything, baby. So As I said, I have like two servers, one based on horror, one based on variety. This is an example of onboarding. I will ask people automated various questions. It's like, oh, do you want to be in a call together? Do you want to see pets, selfies, and food? Do you want to share your musical taste? Do you want to have information on PC gaming, emulation? And it will give people ping roles or channel roles, and they will be able to see certain things or not see certain things. They can honestly come in here and say, I'm not going to make any selection, and they will see the bare minimum of channels. So you go through that, you pick what you want, and then you go to the rules, and it will show you all of the generalized things that you need to know. You know, general drama, be kind, unusual activity, spamming, self-promotion, skill shaming, gatekeeping, heavy topics, hookups, nudity, bios, servers rated in for mature, spoilers, how flares work, being lurker friendly, and reminding people that, you know, ignoring the rules does not excuse them from punishment whatsoever, and the moderators are free to kick anyone depending on who breaks the rules. It's a lot of stuff to take into account, but you're gonna want it set up nice and neatly. And I'm gonna go back from the onboarding settings, and you can see what the server is at this point, what flares people could put on themselves, a server guideline fact of questions that people ask a lot, and I wanted to have that sort of there so you can go and refer to that. Introducing yourself is important. An event planner for activities, a recording discussion, hey, I can't make it to a recording or a collab, that's cool, that's fine, you can let me know here. Stuff like this where it's like, what the fuck is this dude's face? It looks like he ate the most sour lemon I've seen on earth, and that's just so funny. You got your general chat, fan made media, you can post PSN clips, artwork, all that stuff, Kickstarters, fan films, lore viz, everything is nicely condensed. Pets, selfies, food, games for sale, then we go to horror. Horror is sort of a flip, some of the same channels, but as we go down to horror general, it changes. Horror film and TV, that's important. Then you got your Japan obscure J-horror channel that people could post into, Resident Evil chat, other AAA horror games that's not Resident Evil, retro games. Everything is categorized and you're gonna want that category being posted. I will post my server templates if you want to use them as a basis and work off of them from there. This is Renegade Operative signing off. Hopefully this beginner friendly behind the scenes look into Discord servers and how they operate and how they are sort of recognized between people who have experienced Discord before. Hopefully this video turns out to be entertaining to your needs and what you're looking for, and have a happy hunting out there. I know it's hard to do community stuff like this, but also, you know, if you want to join mine as well, you're more than free to do so. Everything is down in the description below. Check it out. It's pretty dank, man. I use the fucking word dank. It's fucking dank, man. It's game developers coming in and posting their indie horror games. Just, oh, it's such a feeling. I love these people in here so much, and hopefully I could share the wealth as well as my experience and giving you the tutorials and things that you need to get along your way. This is my first BTS ever. I will see you guys next time. Stay stylish, keep it fly, and I will talk to you guys soon. See you later.